Welcome back. I'm Brian Gruner and Marcia Garcia here with Recreation. And Marcia is the clubhouse assistant from Clubhouse 3. Welcome.
That's right.
Four months, right?
That's true.
Well, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Welcome. And glad you could join us as well. So you have a lot of activities.
We do.
One, unfortunately, is sold out.
Yes.
Okay.
That one is sold out, and that's the Christmas Day buffet dinner that we have over at Clubhouse 5.
Okay.
So that is sold out at this point.
Oh, that's too bad.
But we do have a waiting list, so you never know.
Okay.
It's worth getting on a waiting list and see what happens.
Okay, good, because we have been telling people about it here as often as we can, so I guess it worked, and you got all the people you needed. So
yeah, no,
perfect.
It's a very popular event, and
it
typically sells out.
Okay. Now, however, you've got one that's coming up this Sunday, December 16th. Tell me about that one.
Yeah, so that's our Tis the Season holiday show over at the Performing Arts Center.
Okay.
Ticket prices are $10 and $7, depending where you want to sit. Mm-hmm. And it's just a very lively entertainment type of performance with the whole holiday theme and singing. They're going to be reading some poetry and things like that. So it should be a lot of fun.
We had the old pros on, I think it was about a week ago, and they were talking about how it's going to be sort of an interactive thing. So the audience can participate as well. And like you said, they're going to have readings. Mm-hmm. Will you be there for this particular one? Because that's in the Performing Arts Center,
oh,
right?
Oh, sure, yeah. And audiences that are there can expect to see a really diverse show. It'll be both funny with lots of laughable actions, but it'll be really serious too. There will be a resident who will be telling her true story of how she crossed the Pyrenees Mountains in the winter of 1942 to escape the Germans.
Oh, wow.
And there will also be a resident who will be telling their story of how they met Charles Dickens' grandson.
No kidding. Oh, that's really exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's nice. Now, do you expect that to fill up? I mean, I guess they should get there early.
Well, we hope so. Tickets are still available.
Okay.
So, but yeah, hopefully we'll get a good turnout and people will really enjoy it.
Awesome. That sounds great. Well, you guys always do so many fun things. Now, that's on Sunday, December 16th, and that starts at 2 p.m. What time will doors open for people?
Doors will open at 1:30.
Okay, perfect. All right, good. All right, super. And what else do you have coming up?
Well, the other thing is New Year's Eve, obviously.
Okay.
So we got a couple of things. We got the Rockin' New Year's over at Clubhouse 5.
Okay.
And that also is an event that typically sells out. And I believe it's $75 for the tickets. And that includes the dinner and the band and drinks and stuff like that.
So, right. So yeah, but it's different than your New Year's Eve.
It's different than
the other
performance at the Performing Arts Center where we have legendary James Daring coming in.
Okay. Okay.
And we actually have a matinee starting at 3:00. Mm-hmm. And the ticket prices are $20 and $25 for that.
Right.
And then at 7 p.m. we have the primary show, mm-hmm. which is $30 and $40.
Okay.
With an option to upgrade to a VIP experience for an additional $20. And that's where you get to meet and greet. And we have a little VIP lounge area with some cocktail tables and drinks and hors d'oeuvres and things like that.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So it should be a lot of fun.
So now the difference between the 3 p.m. show and the 7 p.m. show is that the 3 p.m. does not include appetizers
Correct.
And champagne.
That's
correct.
But the 7 p.m. show does.
Right.
Yes, and that's happening before the show, approximately 6 o'clock.
Okay.
So people probably want to show up between 5:30, 5:45
okay.
to get in and grab their champagne and their
hors d'oeuvres. Oh, okay. All right. That sounds awesome. And then, like you said, you can additional $20 for VIP. And so you have a lounge where the whole band or the singer, or how does it work?
Well, the singer will be there, and then as well as the band. And space is limited, so we are limiting it to only, I believe, 100 people.
Wow.
So people if they want to have that meet and greet experience, then they need to buy it soon.
And so now let's go back to the Rockin' New Year's Eve. So the difference between that is this is a performance where there'll be no dancing. It's basically you're sitting in an audience watching the performance, correct?
Right.
Okay, mm-hmm. But the Rockin' New Year's Eve one is more traditional.
It's more traditional.
Okay.
You come in with your friends, you have a good time, you dance, laugh, and you just wait until the ball drop and ring in the New Year. So
And
that goes until midnight.
I was going to say,
So that goes all the way through midnight, and then you can welcome the New Year in.
Perfect.
James Daring is the actual performance with James Daring is very interactive as well. There's going to be some video, and he's going to be storytelling. There's going to be lots of humor, so it's going to be very entertaining.
Okay. Now, does this one ever sell out, the New Year's Eve one?
We've gotten close in the past, but we've never actually had a celebrity name tied to the New Year's event. It was always a cover band. So this should be a little bit different, and yeah, we're hopeful it's going to sell out. We'll find out.
Well, good. Well, we'll keep pushing it as best as we can for both events. I know we've been mentioning them every day, so hopefully you guys will get a good turnout on both of those. What else is going on? I mean, what does 2019 bring for us? Can you give us a preview?
Definitely. So right in February, we're going to have our Health and Wellness Expo coming up, and that's something that we're gearing towards right now, doing all the prep work and the contacts. And also, we're going to be having a Lunar Festival on Chinese New Year, and that's we're working with the American Chinese Club and different other organizations within our community to bring something like that to them. So,
that sounds
great. Yeah, so right off the bat, in the beginning of the new year, we're going to have a couple of good events.
Good. And what do you like best about working here? It's only been a few months for you. What do you think?
One of my favorite parts is interacting with the residents. There's just so many different stories that come up. I love just learning about their background, learning about different eras and time, and just being able to serve the community is my favorite part, just being as helpful as I can be.
That's nice. And what's your background in?
My background is actually in theatrical production and design.
Oh.
So I was a stage manager for various live shows before coming on board here.
Oh my gosh. Don't tell the old pros of the Theater Guild.
No, they're going to steal her away.
They already know.
I'm sure
they already know. Oh, for sure. Especially the one guy I had on the other day. Mark Bailey, who is the director of one of their performances, because he also has a similar background.
Right.
So, don't tell anybody. Well, thank you both for being on. I appreciate
it, and have
a happy holiday.
All right, you too.
Thank you.
Okay, and don't forget, you guys better get on there and get those tickets, and you can always email recreation at recreation@vmsinc.org, right? Okay, I got it on there. All right, thanks. We'll be right back.